In this tutorial, I'll show you how to make logos explode and break in After Effects without using any plugins. Let's get to it. Here we are in After Effects. First, I'm going to create a new composition. It will be 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second, and 5 seconds for the duration. Click OK, then drag the logo to the timeline. Press S on a keyboard and adjust the scale if needed. I'll decrease mine so it's nicely in the center. After that, I'll right-click on the logo and select Pre-compose. You can name it Logo. And make sure move all attributes is checked, then click OK. After that, open effects and presets window. If you don't see it, go up to your window and make sure effects and presets is checked. And then here we're going to search for Shatter and add this effect to the logo precomp. Then head over to the effect controls panel, set view to be rendered so we can see the logo. Let's move a bit forward so we can see the effect taking place. Then open shape and set pattern to be glass. Then set repetitions to 200, so you get a lot of small pieces or particles. Then set extrusion depth to 0.05, just to have slight depth in the particles. After that, I'm going to open physics. Set randomness to 0.25, viscosity 0.4, and gravity to 0. Now, this could get a bit heavy, so you can drop the resolution to half, and this is the kind of explosion that we get. It looks fine, but I'm going to create a custom gradient map so we can better control the whole explosion or the breaking up of the logo. For that, we need the solid layer. Go up to layer, new solid. You can call this map. And then search for a ramp in effects and presets and add the gradient ramp to the map solid layer. Then in effect control, set ramp shape to radial. And I'm going to set the start of ramp to the center of the composition. And I'm going to swap the colors and drag the end of ramp to this corner so we have this kind of gradient. After that, we can hide this layer so we don't need to see it. Then select the logo comp again and open the gradient settings. Set gradient layer to be a map and set it to effects and masks. And now we can control how the logo breaks up based on our gradient layer that we created. So come to the start of the timeline and create a keyframe for shutter threshold at 0%. Go 3 seconds forward and set it to 100. And now we have this kind of breaking up of the logo, which looks nice. Now I'm going to press U on the keyboard, drag and select the keyframes, right click any of them, keyframe assistant easy ease, or you can press F9 as the shortcut. While the keyframes are highlighted, go into the graph editor, right click, make sure edit speed graph is selected. And I'm going to select the second point and drag this yellow handle all the way to the left. So this is the graph. So we have a very fast animation at the start and then it slows down closer to the end. Now let's exit the graph editor. And this is the explosion or the breaking up of the logo. Now let's add motion blur to the whole animation. And the way we do that is by adding an adjustment layer. So again, go up to layer, new adjustment layer. Make sure this adjustment layer is above all other layers. Then we're going to search for pixel motion blur and add it to the adjustment layer. Now set shutter samples to 8. And that should be a good amount of motion blur. If it isn't, you can increase the shutter angle to something like 360, but I'm not going to do that. 180 is fine. Now, after you've added motion blur, the preview will become extremely slow, but that is the cost of adding nice motion blur. Now, after adding motion blur, let's add glow. So again, we need to create another adjustment layer. So layer, new adjustment layer. Make sure it is at the top. And here we're going to search for glow in the stylize, add it to the adjustment layer. Let's leave the default glow as it is, select it and press Ctrl D to duplicate it. And for the glow 2, set glow radius to 100. And now if we do the preview, you'll see that the whole logo is glowing before the animation happens. And we don't want that to be the case. We want the glow effect to be applied just to the particles after like the explosion has happened. And we can simply keyframe the opacity of our adjustment layer. So let's come to the point where the explosion is like starting, say like frame 15. And select the adjustment layer number 2 where the glow is and press T to bring up opacity. Create a keyframe and set it to 0. Then go forward like 10 frames and set opacity to 100. So now we don't have any glow until the explosion happens. And then we have a sudden transition to the glowing particles. Now let's also add camera lens blur to the same adjustment layer number 2. So if we search for camera lens blur and add it to the second adjustment layer, below the glow effect, I'm going to set blur radius to 6, and we're going to use the same gradient layer as the map that we created for the shutter effect. So in the blur map, let's select the map layer, set it to effect and masks, and we need to invert the blur map, so check invert blur map, and now we have nice and soft glow on the outer particles. So we can go ahead and do the full preview. This is our animation, and what I like to do is add a fade out closer to the end, so something like 3 seconds should be fine. So at 3 seconds, I'm going to select the logo composition and press T on a keyboard, create a keyframe for opacity, go a second forward to 4 seconds and set it to 0. So now after the animation is done, we'll get the fade out at the end. And at this point, we can add a solid layer as the background. So again, layer, new solid, name it BG, click OK, place it below other layers. And I'm going to add fill to control the color of this layer. And let's choose something that match the scene. So maybe nice blue and make it dark, something like this. Click OK. And let's go ahead and do the full preview. And here's our final logo explosion animation. And as always, this is a procedural animation, which means that if we open the logo composition and here decide to use a different logo, so let me grab the Instagram logo, drag it over here, make sure you adjust the size so it matches the previous logo size so that you don't have to adjust anything else. Hide the previous logo, then if we go back to the render composition and do the preview from the beginning, here we have a different logo with the same kind of animation and we don't have to adjust anything. It all just works. So that is it for this one. Thank you guys for watching.